All the nigga wanna have was a very big scarf and $3 in my pocket. Instead I got beat with a switch, but I don't give a fuck, but it's on my body. Scars all up on me, but I run around from everybody. Life lesson learned, I better learn from this bitch, nobody. She pushed me around, she didn't give no motherfucks about it. She broke my heart 3 times, but I ain't getting...
What's up, everybody? It's JT Sports Match, you guys, with another video. This video, I'm here with my Philadelphia Eagles versus the New York Giants Thursday Night Football post-game recap. In the analysis, I'm going to give you guys my thoughts and my reaction to this game. So the Eagles defeated the New York Giants 22-21. The Eagles moved to 2-4-1 on the season. And the New York Giants dropped to 1-6. And if you are a Giants fan, you have to be feeling pretty sick about how this game went. Because this is a game that the New York Giants let slip out of their hands. Okay? Like, the New York Giants defensively played a really good game, okay? Like, aside from the touchdown that Philadelphia had in the first quarter, they didn't really have all that much success offensively. And the Giants offense, I mean, they struggled too. Like, the Giants offense and Philadelphia's offense both struggled in this game. They couldn't move the chains on third down. And it seemed like they were pretty much going three and out. So, I mean, the first quarter, you had the Carson Wentz touchdown. Philadelphia went up 7-0, okay? Then you had the 39-yard touchdown reception by Golden Tate. Score was 7-7. Then Philadelphia had the Jake Elliott field goal, which the Eagles took the lead 10-7. And then in the third quarter, that's when the game started to go in the New York Giants' favor. Wayne Gallman put the Giants on the board, gave them the lead 14-10. And then in the fourth quarter, they had a 21-10 lead with 6 minutes and 17 seconds left. And you think that the game was pretty much over. But I mean, New York, being the New York Giants, they weren't able to make the big plays to seal the game when it mattered the most. You had the big drop by Evan Engram. Carson Wentz got the ball, drives down the field, throws a touchdown to Greg Ward Jr. The score is 21-16. Philadelphia tried to get the two-point conversion. They failed. Okay? Then, Philadelphia, they get the ball back once again. They drive down the field. They enter the red zone. You get a break, and the New York Giants get an offensive face mask penalty on Philadelphia, which backs up the Eagles. And you think that this will help out this New York Giants defense because now, you know, Philadelphia has to go a couple more yards to score the game, win a touchdown to win. So initially, I was thinking that the New York Giants defense was going to be able to get the stop. They were going to be able to win the game because of that penalty on Philadelphia. Well, boy, that was wrong because then a couple of plays later, Carson Wentz hits halfback Boston Scott for the game-winning touchdown. And I mean, for the New York Giants, man, you had 3 turnovers in this game. And I think that it's only fitting that Daniel Jones ended the night fumbling the football, okay? Now, he did throw an interception in this game. I don't think that interception was entirely his fault because he threw it to Evan Engram. Evan Engram got butterfingers. The ball slipped through his fingertips. It got picked off by Jalen Mills. Now, regardless of what you guys want to say, I mean, maybe you can say that it was a ball that was, you know, poorly thrown or whatever. But, I mean, it hit Evan Ingram's hands, man. Like, he should have came down with that. So, I mean, a lot of people are probably going to say that Jason Garrett needs to get fired, that he's not doing his job as offensive coordinator. But, I mean, what can he do? I mean, you can't run the football. The offensive line isn't great. And you have a quarterback that is a turnover machine. Like, put yourself in Jason Garrett's shoes. Tell me what Jason Garrett can do better as offensive coordinator. I don't think he can do any better of a job that he's doing right now. I mean, at this point, it all comes down to execution. And the New York Giants simply were not able to execute when it mattered the most. I mean, the Giants really should have won this game. This was a game that pretty much the Giants had the momentum in for pretty much ever since they came out of the locker room at halftime. Okay? And the Giants defense played fairly well. I mean, you had the big interception when Carson Wentz was trying to throw it to the rookie out of Boise State, John Hightower. It got picked off by James Bradberry. Okay? That's a momentum boost. Then, okay, you have that penalty, like I mentioned earlier, on the Philadelphia Eagles, which happened to be an offensive face mask penalty, and you weren't able to take advantage of that. So, I mean, for the Giants, man, like, it was a bunch of blown opportunities. And, I mean, they had all the momentum on their side. Like, they really should have won this game. I'm still a little bit lost for words that they, you know, folded the way they did. Because they were up 21-10. You were up by 2 possessions. the game was pretty much over. All you needed was one more play, and they simply couldn't do that. So, I mean, for the Giants, man, where do you go from here? Because like I've been telling people in the offseason, this is going to be a rebuilding year for the New York Giants. But, I mean, even though this is a rebuilding year, I mean, look at the Carolina Panthers with Matt Rhule. They're a team that's supposed to be rebuilding, and even then, they have been able to pull off some wins. They have been able to pull off a couple of close games. So, I mean, for the New York Giants, man, like, the defense played fairly well. The defensive line did a good job getting pressure on Carson Wentz. But, I mean, the New York Giants offensive line, man, it's not good. The running game isn't going. And even then, the biggest play of the run game that the New York Giants have had all year was that big run by Daniel Jones, which Daniel Jones ended up falling some way, somehow, even though he had nothing but green grass, Daisy Dukes and roses. He found a way to trip up and not score the touchdown. But New York later on ended up scoring that drive, even though Daniel Jones slipped. But, I mean, that play is the perfect play to sum up the New York Giants season so far. I mean, I just don't really know how to put it into words, because I mean, like, the Giants, I really feel, could have been a lot better on offense. Now, I understand Saquon's not playing. Anytime you lose your best player on offense, okay, you can expect your offense to kind of take a step below production. But I mean, the New York Giants, I mean, this is a team that still has a pretty solid group of wide receivers. And I mean, if Jason Garrett can find a way to get Daniel Jones to actually take care of the freaking football, they could win some more games. So I mean, for the Philadelphia Eagles, you were able to scamper out of this one with the victory. I mean, this really was a game that Philadelphia pretty much should lose, but due to poor execution on the New York Giants' part, you was able to walk out of here with a victory. So I mean, if you're an Eagles fan, do you feel better about the Eagles, or do you feel even more worse about the Eagles than you did coming into this game? I think that, to be honest, you should feel a little bit worse, that you struggled to beat a New York Giants team that hasn't really been all that great offensively. And their defense, aside from the defensive line, I mean, it's pretty average. So, I mean, for Philadelphia, man, like, this was a close game, okay? And I know a lot of people are going to say a win's a win. I'm not saying that. All I'm just saying is that this is a win that the Philadelphia Eagles, is your Eagles fan, is a little bit too close for comfort, okay? Because Philadelphia should have won this game by like 7 points or more, okay? There's no reason why New York should have been competing with the Philadelphia Eagles, given the talent that Philadelphia has, okay? But I mean, Philadelphia's offense wasn't able to get going. They didn't really have a lot of success. It was a bunch of three and outs. And this game was pretty boring offensively. Like, the offenses really couldn't get anything going aside from a couple of big plays. The offense is pretty with lackluster. And I mean, the stats don't reflect how poor the offense is playing in this game. Like, in the second quarter, barely anything happened. In the third quarter, it was pretty quiet. So, I mean, I don't really feel all that confident about the Philadelphia Eagles. I don't have any more confidence in the Philadelphia Eagles than I had before this game started. So, I mean, I'm still pretty concerned about the Philadelphia Eagles. The New York Giants dropped to 1-6. I mean, like I said, this is a rebuilding year. And any New York Giants fans that respecting Joe Judge coming here and getting the New York Giants to the playoffs in his first year, I think you had to be a little bit naive, okay? So, I mean, as a Giants fan, this is a tough loss. You should have won this game. And for Philadelphia, I mean, still don't really have a lot of confidence in this team. And I think a lot of Philadelphia Eagles fans will agree with that statement. So you guys let me know how you guys feel about this game down in the comment section down below. Make sure that you guys like the video, subscribe to the channel for more NFL videos and content. And thanks for watching.